Welcome to Winnipeg, Manitoba, and the Canada Life Center for Game 3 of the World Junior Lacrosse Championship, the final game here at the championships. I am Stephen Stamp, joined by Brian Shanahan, and we are excited to be bringing you this final matchup. And Shanny, the second game, Canada West, much closer, but didn't get the start they were really looking for.
It was a terrible start by Canada West. In fact, in the first 2.5 minutes, they allowed the East to score 3 quick goals, and it started just 29 seconds in when they gave Jordan Aki a clear-cut breakaway. He's got all kinds of time to slow down and make some move. That makes it 1-0. And here's Tanner Buck, kind of goes in almost untouched. They wanted to stop. He was the one guy they wanted to stop. And here's just an unfortunate change by Jackson Kluchuk, and it gave Eddie Q wide open. That went up 3-0. But in the fourth quarter, it was different. It was 3 goals by the West, and that first one, that second one there was Onagi. Nolan Oakey scored the first one. Onagi just beats his man cleanly there for 3 goals. So they actually outscored the East 3-0 in the fourth quarter, and that's the way they want to play, and that's the way they want to start this game.
And they want more consistency, obviously. They had a very good game. I mean, 3-0, like you said, in the fourth quarter for Canada West over Canada East. That was the first time they'd scored 3 goals in a row.
Yeah.
And their defense was terrific in the second half.
Yeah, there was a lot of good positives to end the game. They want to carry that forward and get the start they were looking for yesterday.
We are just about ready to roll. The teams are on the floor. Canada West is wearing their white. That is Stu Stirparn, the head coach. They will be going right to left, and we will be back with the start right after this. Here we go, lacrosse friends. The final game of the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Canada West, as we mentioned, in the white. The home team going right to left with Caden Onagi winning the faceoff for Canada West. Canada East on your left, going left to right in the red jerseys. Canada West with the first possession. Here's Nolan Oakey, who had that beautiful behind the back goal in the fourth quarter last night that we saw in the highlights beforehand. Here's Troy Gutowski, the local boy who leads the tournament in assists with 6. That pass doesn't get through though. Here's Michael Grace on the break. Canada East's first possession. Going back the other way, he'll hand it off to the captain, Tanner Buck, leading scorer. He's got 7 goals. He has been dynamic, but 5 of those in the first game. Canada West did a better job in the second game, holding him to 2. See how they do tonight. Here's a shot by Anderson. It's blocked by Hunter Agus. Garrett Brockmeyer takes a look to make sure he's clear before he picks up that loose ball as the 30.
And the West has not opened the scoring in any games yet. And it looks like the West is starting with a penalty here.
Yeah, not what you want, obviously. Brockmeyer will take the slashing call. Not sure what exactly. We'll see what the strategy is for West dealing with Tanner Buck, who is obviously such a weapon. Last night we did see Easton Ong matched up on him quite a bit. I don't know that they want Garrett Brockmeyer on him.
And
a
Buck,
bit younger player.
Although he got 2 goals yesterday, they were early goals. So they did a better job of him throughout the game, but not a good start, you know, when it was... You know, 1 minute in the game, they allowed him to almost walk
Eddie
in.
Eddie Q passes down low to McGrath. He rips it home. They go strong right instead of strong left, as they've been doing a lot. Works out perfectly with Q down to McGrath and the quick stick finish.
Oh, yeah, and that was definition quick stick. Ruska knew where that ball was going. He knew it was going to McGrath. Ruska got over, but the shot from McGrath was just fast enough that it didn't matter, it got in. And yeah, nice little setup by Eddie Q, who I think has had a great tournament. Like, I think after Tanner Buck, he's probably been their best offensive player.
Yeah, and he's been scoring more. I mean, Eddie Q with...
3 yesterday.
Yeah, 3 goals. He's got 4 goals and an assist coming into the game. McGrath had 3 goals, but they were all in one game. He had the hat trick in game 1. So good for him to get rolling again in this one. So 1:08 in, Canada East has jumped out front. We'll see how Canada West rebounds. That has been a real theme, is how they respond to challenges. They've been getting better as they go, maturing, growing together as a team. We'll talk about that more. Buckta gets it over to Buck. Buck right now being watched by Aiden Danby. They go far side. That's Buckta. Sam Dramnitsky Here's Buckta driving to the net, gets the shot. Ruska stops it. Ruska gave up those three goals early on, about five shots. There's a save on Buck. Three goals early, and then really steeled himself and sharpened up.
He sure did. That was a nice save he just made on Buck. Buck has been very dangerous from that position. We've talked all tournament about how dangerous his shot is from in that slot area.
Here's Patrick Dodds. Gets the pass over to Basisti. Zach Basisti, the youngest player in the tournament, just misses on that one. He's been pretty sharp, looked way better in game two than game one. Here's Will Cecile breaking out, and they are on him immediately, maybe remembering that he has two goals in this tournament. They're both game winners. He has the two game-winning goals.
A couple of pretty goals in each game.
McGrath wide open, all the way to the net, scores! And that's exactly the type of breakdown West was worried about.
Sam Marshall just overextended himself on McGrath there. Watch, the pass comes out. I'm not sure if he's going for the stick. We're going to see it in a second. And it's an isolation. It's just a one-on-one play, but he really got caught out of position. I think
he was trying to
intercept the pass.
Yeah.
And cheating, yeah. So he steps up thinking he could intercept the pass, didn't, and nice finish by McGrath for his second of the game.
Hot start again. We're 2.5 minutes in, 2-0 Canada East.
And that was the assist by Buck.
Mm-hmm. Extended battle in Aki. Jordan Aki pulls it back between his legs. It's grabbed there by Michael Grace. Ethan Riggs staying for the help as there's pressure from West. They clear it. Aki actually takes that pass again. Gets it ahead to Matthew Wright. Wright took a look. Somebody called for it. I think it was Eddie Q. Called for the ball cutting to the middle, and Wright thought about it, but wasn't really there. Now they go back door to Q. Doesn't get there. Dramnitsky. The shot clock was reset. Did that get through to Ruska?
I don't think so.
Well, it's a fresh 30, and Dramnitsky has behind the back pass. Gets through to Wright. There's a gradual change happening, and a couple of Canada East players just stay. They had gotten to the bench. That's Tyler Davis with it. He and Buckter were both at the bench and were just sent back out. The pass to Dramnitsky doesn't connect, and Ruska scoops it up. Pass to Easton Ong. Easton Ong and Matthew Wright here. They are two of the fastest players in the tournament. Ong loses the ball as he stumbled. Wright's got it. Back check. Great job by Jackson.
Must be a slippery part of the floor. A couple of stumbles.
Here's Gutowski. Oakey lost it for a moment, takes a big bump there. Here's Dodds. Finds Gutowski, rips one, it's high, comes straight out to Brendan Boyle, who's been outstanding. And there's the break for Blake Dunford. He is pouring in, shoots and misses. And there's four white jerseys closest to that ball. Oh, but it gets away from Marshall. He's gonna scoop it up. But that allows Dunford to get right on him.
And that breakaway opportunity by the East, that's something we've seen this whole tournament, is the West missing big shots, creating big rebounds. That's how the game started yesterday, a big rebound that turns on a missed shot that turns into a transition play the opposite way.
Schmerman up on an offensive set. That's a drive to the net by Arthur Miller. He's stopped. Loose ball. Nice job by Dodds to fight off Boyle. Give Schmerman a chance, but right. Great position. He is such a solid player. I think Matt Wright may be the best defender in this tournament.
Yeah, he's played very well.
Ben Trumbull hands it off there to David Anderson. This is McGrath. Hayden Coulter cutting to the net, nicely picked up by Brockmeyer. Now Anderson gets through, and there's some help from Brockmeyer. That is what West wants to see, is that help defense, pushing guys into help, being there for the slides. That shot by Buck, that's a tough one with Ong on him. Behind the net now. The net's out of place. Play does continue. And the goalie's actually responsible to get that back. Ruska will set it up. Time is flying. We're already 5 minutes into this game. It's 2-0 Canada East. We'll be back at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship right after this break here on TSN. BioSteel is proud to be hydrating the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Zero sugar and eco-friendly sports hydration. Head to biosteel.ca to get yours today. Canada West will start with possession. The score in this game is 2-0 for Canada East. That makes it 27-18 cumulatively. It is a three-goal three-game total goal series. Here's Onagi breaking through. The slide help is there. Then the nice recovery.
It is a total goal series, but you know the goals for the West, they just want to win this game. They're not, you know, if they get a chance, they're going to think about total goals. But really, their objective is to get a win. That would be a big success for them if they can win this game.
And conversely, Canada East is not thinking, let's just not lose by seven.
No, no, exactly.
Eddie Q with the shot. Ball skips out. Evan Susie couldn't quite corral it, so Buck back to Q. He might, I thought he might let it go again, but too much traffic. Over to Buck to set up. He's watched by Krywoken, who's been very solid for the West. That's Susie on Q. He fights through. Behind the back, right in the belly. Nice try by Coulter. Didn't quite get where he wanted.
Look at the great job by the East.
Yeah, that's Buck and Q on Marshall with the forecheck, and they cause the turnover. Canada West on that one had four players on the bench while Marshall was on his own, just waiting to see which way they were going to go, and the four defenders came out when he lost it. Here's McGraw looking for the hat trick already. Turned aside nicely there by Marshall. Little offside shot by Tyler Davis just missed. They've got 10 on the shot clock. McGraw down to Davis. McGraw's going to rip it. It's wide. That'll be an over and back. And the 30 expires exactly when they're blowing down the over and back as well. Shenny, last night the 10-9 win for Canada East. Four of their goals came in transition, one shorthanded. So you know West wants to stop that. And one of the things we've talked about, when they're shooting, they've got everyone going down low. They need someone heading back when a shot's coming. We'll see if they do that. Right now, we just saw Basisti was sitting up high. He cuts in now and gets to take a pass. And Dodge is back at center. So they clearly are addressing that.
Yeah, exactly. And then I talked about it earlier. They're missing the net big, creating some big rebounds for transition. But yeah, the problem is what you just said, is that everybody in offense is going forward. Nobody's going back.
Stu Sturpharn would appear to have impressed that message upon them so far. 5 seconds left to shoot as it's picked up by Anderson off the miss. There's another miss. That's going to be another over and back. And again, just as the 30 expires.
And the West has to be happy with their last two sets of defense. Anytime you get that 30-second shot clock to go, you know your defense is doing a good job.
Keen Moon starts with possession, flicks it to the far side. Well, now you got it back to Moon. He gets space, saved by Landon Kells. Here's a run for Dunford. There's already one and now two defenders out for Canada West, so they are clearly paying attention to that. They're just going to be upset that they gave up the one breakaway. Well, two breakaways, one goal, before they got on it. Here's Anderson. Hits McGraw. Great pass leading him as Danby was right with him. But Danby recovers, stays on him. Pick coming. Shot by McGraw. Nice save.
Oh, my.
Oh, no.
No goal, because I think, who was it that was in the crease? No, I think Butka was standing in the crease as that ball rolled in.
Yeah, if there's a moment, we might want to get another look at that one, just see what it was. I was impressed with Easton Ong kind of blowing up the pick by just shoving his guy out of the way. So he couldn't actually even apply the pick. Here's Dodds. Tries the feed through. It's knocked down by Wright. Gets back to Dodds. They've got five to get a shot off. May have to do it on his own. Nope, it's too high for Basisti. It's going to roll all the way down. Look at the hustle on Eddie Q, hoping to get something last night.
Eddie Q scored a goal that way yesterday, hustling for a loose ball because the referee blows it in as soon as you get there.
Davis, little fake. Pretty good positioning there by Hunter Agus. Ball pops away and Krywoken grabs it after Q couldn't take the pass. And Krywoken spins into space. Gets it to Moon. Keen Moon has scored five goals, every one of them jumping up and dunking into the goal.
Yeah. And you called him Keith, too.
I know. I blame you. Onagi, swim move. Dunford recovers nicely.
And I'd like to see a little bit more isolation on Onagi, if that's possible. He scored a beautiful goal yesterday, beating his man one-on-one.
Rebound came off the board right to Dodge. He's stopped by Kells. Quick outlet pass to Bukta, but lots of white defenders out. West doing a better job getting there. Yeah, that's a great point. I mean, Onagi's so quick and so slippery. I think he's been very good in this series. McGraw getting a pick from Buck. Well defended, the save by Ruschka. Gets away from Ong, but he grabs it back.
Oh, nice.
Slips by McGraw, all alone. Oh, just too high. Comes straight out to Trumbull. He'll get to Buck. Again, though.
Almost a beautiful finish to a great shift by Easton Ong. You mentioned it. He is the guy they're matching up against Tanner Buck.
Which means they're going for quickness.
They're going for quickness. Both guys.
Big guy to pound on him.
Both of them are 5'9". Pretty much the same weight. But, yeah, sometimes it's about footwork, not about size.
Yeah, and that last shot, Buck had a little too much space. And that's, I mean, Ong's gone off for a shift, the switch. Agus picks up Buck and was maybe just a touch slow getting there. We're already at the second break. It is 2-0. We'll be right back after this break on TSN. Tech Savvy is a proud sponsor of the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Visit techsavvy.com/CLL for affordable Canada-wide internet plans. We have gone 8 minutes without a goal here in game three of the WJLC. And that is a good sign for Canada West, Shanny, even though they're being outshot heavily so far.
Yeah, the shots on net are 12-3 for the East so far.
On net is critical there because West has been missing.
Yes.
Here's Buck getting by Ong, shooting wide. Picked up nicely there. Great snag by Krywoken. Gets it over to Ong and he'll hand it off to Dodds. The offense takes shape. Here's the youngster, Basisti. Three-time minor nationals all-star at Bantam and twice at Midget. Gutowski comes to Arthur Miller. Nice switch on the defense. So they go to the far side. Onagi, I think that was blocked. I think it looked like it actually went off the East defender. Grace is going to get there first. Didn't matter because the shot clock was about to expire.
And good job by Onagi to get back and make sure there was going to be no breakaway on that. But it was another, it might have been deflected, I'm not sure, but another shot that missed the net by quite a bit to create a big rebound.
There's a quick release by Anderson. He doesn't like that one, as it definitely got away from him. Bounces way up to almost to the second level. No pressure, so Marshall can just toss it ahead to Oakey. Nolan Oakey cutting underneath. Gets by Cecile, but pretty good trail by Cecile.
That was good help.
Yeah, help from Brendan Boyle. Boyle has really impressed me in this tournament. Here comes Aki. And here's Krywoken off the bench. Boy, West is doing a really good job since the first couple of minutes of taking away those transition
chances. Yeah, that first guy is getting back to take away the breakaway, and the East is just holding up for teammates.
Danby on Buck. You can see the little chess game. The offhand push gets away with it. Danby with the loose ball. He's knocked over, and he's grabbing his knee. And Tanner Buck actually points to Danby and says, go ahead and blow it down. They were teammates. Actually, no, they weren't, because Buck was on Canada in 2018 and Danby in 19. But if we actually get a chance to, if we have that earlier goal, we're going to take a look at this first.
Oh, yeah, so. Yeah,
not a lot of contact. He just.
But it looked like, you know, while he was up in the air, whether he got a bit of a bang on the knee. It looks like he's favoring his knee.
Yeah. He grabbed the knee. Whether it's when he got banged in a twister, I think it's when he came down. He and McGraw did kind of bump into each other as they both jumped up for the loose ball.
And the West has already lost McGuigan in the first game.
So one thing to keep in mind for this tournament is, as we're going to take a look at this first. This is the one that's waved off, Shanny.
Yeah, was this McGraw again coming in that?
He landed in the crease. And then you see the ball go.
No question.
Yeah, great shot.
Yeah, if the ball goes in the net and you land in the crease afterwards, that's fine. But he was in the crease as soon as he took that shot.
You even see occasionally where somebody takes the shot, it hits the goalie, they run through the crease, the player, and then the ball trickles through. That's okay if you're reestablished outside the crease if you got both feet back out.
Yep.
And Danby is up, getting a round of applause, or the sticks banging on the boards from both teams. Definitely favoring that right leg. Hope he's okay. He's indicating to his teammates and coaches what happens.
Let's see where he goes. Yeah. He is going to the dressing room.
I was going to point out that normally this is a 20 and under tournament. This year, because of last year's tournament being canceled by the COVID pandemic, we do have 21-year-olds. There are six on Canada East, two on Canada West. And I think that has been a difference in how quickly these teams have come together. And you've seen East starting out at a higher level of play and West really improving more and more as they go. We'll see if that holds tonight. Buck gets by, but Ong recovers. Nice job not to hold. I was just about to say, that's going to be a hold, but he got off just in time. Bruschka steals the pass and hands it off to Evan Gartner. Rumbles up into the offensive zone.
West has got to be happy with their defensive game lately, but they got to get the offense going.
Dodds will try to do so. Gives it to Onagi. Tries to pass it through last couple seconds of the shot clock. Had to force that one. It just wasn't there.
Oh, yeah, just good defense by the East. There was nothing opening up.
Tonight's officials, Roger Nurse, the head ref, Jesse Smith and Kevin Hilder on the floor. Lane Hartung running the shot clock. He's in the box. Here is Davis. Watched closely by Marshall. Goes to the far side. Anderson gets a screen, rips it. That I thought that went into the bench bit, but they've got four on the shot clock. Nice job by Krywoken to just tie up Davis until the shot clock goes. Here's Moon. See if he can create something. Goes over to Onagi. Great positioning. There's the pick. A nice help by Onagi.
Very nice play set up by Onagi, who's been one of the better offensive players on the West.
But the defense was equal to it. Here's Trumbull handing it off to Buck. Big pick by Liam McGrath. This is Buckta, watched by Agus. Coulter. Around the seals at the top and kind of a little sidearm shovel shot that just hit a defender. They've got three to shoot. Buck will get one off. Ruska stops it. Interesting matchup of the goalies tonight with Ruska against Landon Kells for Canada East, as 2 years ago they were teammates for Canada at the World Juniors in Mississauga. We'll get to that a bit more in a moment, as here is the offensive set. Dodds cuts underneath. Can he get a shot off? He does. It's a little wide again. Oh no, they said it touched the player. Doesn't matter though. It touched Kells, but it doesn't matter. We're into the final 15 seconds. West East will get a sixth attacker out. Here's Tyler Davis. They've got 8 seconds. McGrath saying settle down. They've only got 4 seconds, though. Anderson ducks through, going to try and get a shot off. He does, but it's wide. And we will go to the first quarter intermission with the score 2-0 for Canada East here at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship. We'll be right back with more action on TSN. Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the World Junior Lacrosse Championship. And Troy Gutowski is a local boy making good here at the World Juniors. Let's learn a little bit more about him.
So I played in 2 Junior B Founders Cups, and that was awesome. And I really wanted to go, you know, test my skills and prove to myself that I could play Junior A. And, you know, I found out that NCAA wasn't for me, and I'm getting a great education at Red River College, being a nursing student. And I was just able to do both and while staying at home. Yeah, playing in my hometown where the Jets play. It's a dream come true. My family's really excited to see me play. I'm excited to play here.
Well, Gutowski's only got one goal, but he leads the tournament in assists with 6. And sometimes there's guys you don't really notice on offense, but they're involved all the time. And he's one of these guys who's made a lot of nice passes. He set up some goals, yes, and yesterday he got 4 assists. There's one of them, and just watch number 47. Always, the ball is going through him, and he's finding the open man. And that's a nice sell of a shot before he puts that down low for Jason Kluchuk. And I think he also set up that beautiful over-the-shoulder goal by Nolan Oakey, too.
Nolan Oakey, yeah. I think the Jackson Kluchuk goal was my favorite pass that he's made. That was such a nice little touch pass.
Yeah, he kind of stepped in like he was going to take a shot and just sort of flips it over.
Ben Trumbull taking this faceoff for Canada East. Rather than Jordan Ackie, who's generally been taking them, Trumbull stepped in yesterday, took six faceoffs, won five of them.
It's pretty good.
Not bad. See how he does on this one against Onagi, who is very sharp on the faceoffs. Oh, that was a false start by Trumbull. Oh, somebody's got to go get that ball. His play will be blown in. Susie missed it for a moment. He's going to go to the bench, get another forward out. Arthur Miller was flattened by Ethan Riggs away from the ball. Here's the pass to Oakey. Gets a little pick. That shot hit Michael Grace in the foot. Moon has it, and Riggs is over there banging him. Riggs is all over the floor, sometimes in a very good way. Sometimes you might want him to back off a little. Here's Matt Wright, all alone. We've seen him do this. Off the crossbar and out. Very sharp, good positioning by the official to make sure they saw that one. Here's Dunford fighting the loose ball, but it's going to be picked up. That's an 8-second count as time runs out.
Yeah, I guess. The West had possession of that ball. If they never got possession, the 8-second wouldn't have started.
Here's a peek. Oh, great overhead view. You can see it crossbar and dead out. Yeah. Here's McGrath trying to get under Agus. Recovers nicely. Agus on him. That shot's wide. McGrath's high. He's going to go get his own loose ball on the rebound. 12 seconds to go. Gives it to Anderson. Hard shot. That's off the shaft of the stick of Ruska. So it's a fresh 30 as Anderson scoops that one up. McGrath was thinking shot. He's got Gartner on him. Gets it now. It's off the shin of Gartner. Ruska was reaching
out. He thought about it.
Oh, backdoor cut to Q, and Ruska had to be sharp. I want to give a quick shout out to Lane Hartung. Oh, there's a chance. The other end by Dodds. Didn't quite get what he was looking for, but yesterday the one goal that was just on the crossbar and he was right in position, emphatic that it was a goal. I saw him in the lobby today. He said, did you get a replay? I was like, oh yeah, it was in. We saw it hit the mesh.
Oh, that was the one they called? Yeah, that's right. They called it in, yeah.
Where the two refs looked at each other and Hartung was emphatic with his nodding. He had it. He knew. Perfect positioning. The refs aren't always perfect, but it's nice to give them some credit when they do get them really well. Turning, spinning shot by Buck to goes wide. The shot clock will expire on Buck. That ball did go in, but it was well after the shot clock. Well after, like a good second.
Oh, yeah.
Krywolken ahead, and Moon gives it up to Dodds. A little stumble. That is the one spot where Dodds just stumbled, is the one kind of bumpy part on this turf that was brought in. It's sitting really nice. It's a good turf. Obviously, it's in good shape, but that one spot just will not settle. Blocked by Will Cecile, and he is off to the races, but Onagi with him. Ducks underneath. Oh, my goodness, Will Cecile. That's another nice move. He has been outstanding in transition.
He has been, and you know what? Ruska's been outstanding in net, too. The shots on net were 14-4 starting this quarter, and they've had about five good scoring chances. I'll check the shots in just a second.
Gutowski looking for that pass, catches it after a moment ago, hanging the stick out, but recovering. But there's a shot and a goal by Nolan Oakey. He loves cutting through the middle and getting those passes. Makes the most of this one.
Yeah, and this is something the West really needed. That's their first shot of the second quarter. In fact, they've only had, and look who makes a pass again, Gutowski. For, I think that's his seventh assist, and Oakey's benefited from his passes a few. That's a really nice shot. He didn't have a lot of room and just put that on the right side. But only the sixth shot on net for the West.
We talked a bit earlier about the goaltenders matching up against each other. And in 2019 in Mississauga against the Iroquois Nationals in the final, Ruska started, gave up five goals, and was pulled. Landon Kells came in. Canada came back to win 13-10. Those five goals came in just about 10 minutes. So Ruska wants to perform well in this final. So far, you know, it wasn't great giving up the first two, but he has really, again, as he did last night, solidified himself.
And even in that game, in the gold medal game a couple of years ago, that was not Ruska having a bad game. That was just the Iroquois came out on fire.
Nice D by Agus as Davis tried to get under him. Here's a chance for Q, scores near side, just inside the post. There, Ruski was just off his pipe.
Yeah, nice shot. I think you're gonna see this is probably a screen and Q just, you know, comes around the man and shoots through some bodies. Again, watch the ball go across. Look at all the bodies in there. I think that's hard for a goaltender to track that ball.
This is a great angle.
From another angle. Just a nice shot.
Yeah, I mean, from that angle, you can't even see the spot the Q hit. It wasn't a lot. He's such a sharp shooter. Eddie Q out of Mississauga plays for the Oakville Buzz in the Ontario Junior Lacrosse League.
Going to Yale along with David Anderson. I've heard of that school. Pretty bright school.
The ball is knocked down by Ong. He bobbled it a bit. Now he gets it. That gave Buck to time to get back. Ong is thinking about it. A couple of fakes. And I think they were saying, no. Hang on. Oh, Oakey. Will he let that one rip? He won't, as Riggs was right up on him. Katowski over to Basisti. Moon with the outside rip. It's going to come right back out to him, but it's too far. Oh, that's trouble if Riggs is gone. There's Katowski after him. Riggs shoots, misses, but it's going to go out to Buck. They've still got, they got a fresh 30. Why was the clock reset?
I don't know if the referee thought that hit the goalie. I didn't think it did. I thought it was just a missed shot, but maybe he saw it better than we did.
They are closer than us. We have a nice overhead view, though. Sometimes that gives us a bit of an edge, actually. I think the angle from up here. Anderson, watched by Gutowski back on a D shift and knocks it down. And here's a break the other way. Oakey, the forward who was back there as well. They had two forwards caught. It worked out pretty well and almost led to a scoring chance. Now here comes Matt Wright the other way. He's wide open as McGrath, who scores. Oh, and West has been doing so well limiting, and then that's just a big break for McGrath.
Yeah, the quick turnover, back up the floor. You know, there's somebody coming off the bench quickly, and McGrath's got his hat trick goal in the first half and all kinds of room. Some really good hands, some nice fakes from the Halifax native.
Yeah, started the season with the St. Margaret's Rebels. Four to one, Canada East has pulled ahead. And they'll come away with this faceoff. Blake Dunford, who is just so gritty, getting in there and coming away with it. Fights through the check from Brockmeyer. Waiting for some forwards to come out, gets it to Davis. He's staying as they're down to 17 on the shot clock. Q can't get that pass, but he'll hustle back and get it. Eddie Q, so athletic, quick, and he can jump so fast. Gets up. There's a hard rip.
Very similar to that goal he just scored, but this time Ruska's up for the task.
And I think the defender was a little bit more out of the way, not screening him on that one. Here's Buck going underneath. Buck almost gets it back. Brockmeyer kind of waited to pick it up, and I'm not sure why. That gave Q a chance to get on him. He might have been worried about it back in. Q is swallowed up by three defenders. And it's shoveled ahead by Brockmeyer. Two on one. Ong. It's a three on two. Shot by Dodge, just off the arm of Kells. Cecile gets it, outlet.
Look up the floor again, two on one.
And Pouliot had Anderson with him if he'd caught that cleanly, but by the time he picked it up again, Agus had picked up Anderson on the two on one. So East will take their time and set up. Bukta with the give, looking for the go, but Anderson doesn't like the look. Tries to pass into the corner, it goes away, and Schmerman picks it up. Gets it to Agus, nobody up the floor. So West is gonna have to slow things down a bit. Kluchuk came to be the help, gets the pass, and Caden Noseworthy on him. Keely over to Dodge, behind the back, doesn't get through to
Michael Keen Grace Moon. Did a great job just putting his stick in that passing lane. That looked like a great scoring chance, a bit of a two-on-one in the corner, and Grace's stick was just right spot. Oh my.
Trumbull in transition, there's Buck. Behind the back is Gartner trying to get out on him. That's not a spot you want to give Buck.
No, there was two red bodies on that side and only one defender.
Davis hard shot, arm save, Ruska. Here's Trumbull. Oh, he was going for the same spot as Q. It's off of Ruska. Trumbull's going to get it back. Now, will he stay for another set, or is he going to go to the bench after he makes this pass? He's going to stay. Get up there. Have a go. Goes to set some picks. Buck feed through to Davis. Oh, that's off the crossbar. That comes down and lands just under our booth. And we have reached the break. We're over halfway through the second quarter. It's 4-1 for Canada East here at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship. We'll be right back. BioSteel is proud to be hydrating the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Zero sugar and eco-friendly sports hydration. Head to biosteel.ca to get yours today. Canada East with possession. Eddie Q starts with 7:25 to go in the second quarter.
Eddie Q is only 5'8", but he's 200 pounds. And you know, we've seen him with his equipment off. He is built solid. So when he puts his shoulder down, he's pretty strong.
Q comes around the seals, passes it over to Buck. We were talking, a group of us, about something that happened in a game. And here's Buck wide open and scores. That's a tough break for Ong. He toppled, just tripped on his feet and went to the floor. And Buck's so dangerous.
Yeah, and I think if we're going to watch a replay, I think Sam Marshall pushed his man, kind of made it difficult for Ong to keep with Buck. We'd have to go back a little farther to see where that developed. But, you see, he pretty much pushed his man, I think, into Ong, you know, so as he was trying to push his man out of the way.
We're going to go have a discussion in the penalty box with the timekeepers. Just checking on something, but Aki and Onagi there waiting for the faceoff.
Let's have another look at this goal. And you're going to see it's a two-man game. And watch, Marshall comes up high and tries to push his man out of the way. But watch what it does. And his man ran right into Ong. And that's the problem. I mean, there's two types of ways you can play defense. You can try to clear your man out of the way, or you can back off. Sometimes it's wiser to back off, because if you're the offensive guy and somebody gives you a push, it almost gives you the right to accidentally bump into the defender. And that's what happened there. He bumped into Ong, and Ong couldn't stay with Buck, and Buck scores an easy goal.
And of course, with Marshall up there as well covering his man, it was tough for the guys on the other side with the strong right set to get over there, because they're across on the far side of the floor.
Yeah, we always talk about the two-man game, and you know, that's standard across. They will try to separate the offense into a group of two and a group of three and spread them out as much as possible, keep the center open so that help can't come.
He's setting up, Buck on the near side. He gets underneath and scores. It's another one. Oh, but he's saying crease. The toe on the crease. Roger Nurse in perfect position.
No goal.
It was a crease call. Gutowski looking for Basisti. He's picked up very nicely by Cecile. And that save by Kells. Grabbed by Boyle. Out to Cecile. And you see how well they're clearing. McGraw was off the bench and deep. But there were two West defenders between Cecile and McGraw. Probably a good decision to pull that one down. Here's Eddie Q. But we were talking, I said, the other day about something that happened in one of the games amongst us and the coaches. Here's a chance. That's a goal.
My.
That one's good. David Anderson.
Oh, Anderson gets the finish. But where do you see this pass from Eddie Q? Over the shoulder. And the defender was on Anderson pretty good. Here, let's see. Okay, so Eddie Q in the corner here. He sees him cutting. Oh, I guess there was nobody on Anderson at first. And I think by the time the defender came over, it was
Basisti,
a little bit too
actually,
late.
The forward that got caught back.
Yes, yeah, you're right. And there was, it was two guys. It looked like two guys looking at Eddie Q. He makes that over-the-shoulder pass through the middle. And a goaltending change. We're getting Getty in net. And I've said this before. Sometimes you change a goaltender. It's not because of how your goalie is playing. It's how the team is playing. It kind of sends a message. It's almost like you want to tell the guys, you're letting him down. We have to put in another goalie. Oh, my.
What a chance right away from McGraw, and he scores about 8 seconds into the tenure of Justin Getty.
And that's what you don't want when you make a goaltending change. And a defensive breakdown for the West off the faceoff that had to be 5 or 6 seconds after that last goal. And McGrath having a great game, just his fourth already. Look at this. McGrath, I believe, came off the bench. He did. He's got some nice hands.
He does, and he primarily plays defense. He does say he's played everywhere. He's comfortable everywhere. But, yeah, 9 seconds, the official difference between those two goals.
That's right. He's playing for Orangeville. He's playing defense for the Orangeville Northmen.
Yep.
But I would be very surprised if he eventually doesn't move to offense on that team.
Could be, could be. He did play defense for Canada in his previous appearance at the World Juniors. Here's Buck. Gets under Agus, misses a bit on the far side. Didn't touch the goalie, so no fresh reset. 10 seconds on the clock. Anderson, bounce pass to McGrath, who has 5. Game of his life, I would think.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
5 goals in just the first half. And Eddie Getty is not liking what he's seeing right now. And he's, you know, and Ruska can...
I mean...
Oh, my gosh. They have been losing their men and not playing good defense. I mean, we saw the goal by Anderson as he cut in, you know, a little too late, and so was that play there.
Is that bad D by Hunter Agus? I thought he was pretty close. It was a beautiful touch pass, and McGrath had to go complete crossover hands.
Yeah, but I don't think pretty close is good enough. I really don't. You know, these guys... I think you got to be right on him.
Didn't get the cross check on him.
Don't mean to be picking on the West players, but you know, you can't just be hanging on a guy.
And boy, I thought Q was getting under Schmerman there, and Schmerman recovered. There's a shot and a hand saved by Getty. Another chance, but boy, Bryce Schmerman, excellent footwork to get in position because that was looking like it was going to be scary again. Here comes Easton Ong for the West, up over center. Kluchuk. To Gutowski.
Shots on net 25-6.
He's just playing a complete game. That shot was blocked out front. It may have actually hit Nolan Oakey. Dodds will pick it up, but he's out of time. And that will be taking us to the final break of the first half. The score 8-1 for Canada East. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. We'll be right back to World Junior Lacrosse Championship action on TSN after a quick break. Tech Savvy is a proud sponsor of the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Visit techsavvy.com/CLL for affordable Canada-wide internet plans. We're going to take a look at Liam McGrath, who is on fire and enjoying himself.
5 goals. What did he get? The first game he got a hat trick, I believe. Didn't get
nothing
any
in the second.
Yesterday, 5 goals today. And now I think he's tied with Buck for most goals in the tournament. Actually, Buck might have moved up to 9 goals. Yeah, Buck's got 2 this game.
Did McGrath somehow know he was on camera there? Because he was voguing a little bit. Pressure on Eddie Q. But Ong is not going to be able to deter him. I did start a couple times to say, we talked about a play where someone ran into Q. We were talking, they said, oh, and ran into Q. We're like, oh, that's the end of it. He is so solid. Anderson kind of flicks it out of the double team. Krywoken looked like he just wanted to bang Coulter away and let Agus get it. And now Agus is just mucking. I think they think there's less time on the shot clock.
I was
going to
say earlier on, with 11 seconds left on the shot clock, you shouldn't be mucking.
No. But it'll work out. I think we had a push on the back. I think Tanner Buck just said, I'm just going to see what I can do because we can't go around these guys right now. Agus under some pressure from right. He's trapped at center. That's not a good spot to be with the over and back rule in effect.
He probably had an outlet earlier. I don't think he had to run into that trouble.
But once you miss it,
once you don't make it, and these guys are so good at double teaming. Once you're double teaming, there's no room to look around.
And East would have seen his outlet and taken it away as soon as they could. Pass down to McGrath with the hot touch. Q ducks underneath, triple teamed, but fights through it behind the back. What a save. Oh, but tucked home on the rebound. Ben Trumbull up for another offensive shift and makes the most of it.
Yeah, I think he got a goal yesterday too, Trumbull.
Yeah, that was in transition.
Transition.
That was a nice little sidearm sweep right to the far corner.
This is just another great play by Eddie Q to muscle his way to the net, get a nice over-the-shoulder shot. Yeah, look at this. Put the stick down. Three bodies that he squeezes through to still get the shot on that. Nice save by Getty. You kind of hate that when you're the goaltender. And I'm sure Rush had some problems with, you know, so many shots on him. And he makes Getty makes this big save only to see a rebound pop out to another player to pop it in.
And the one thing, you know, they always say, coaches say, you've been saying, go for the cross check, don't go for the stick. Cross check. Sam Marshall, the first slide help, absolutely went for the cross check, but Q is just so strong, he just fought through it and protects the ball. He moves it back and forth so well, so quickly, such vision. Boy, that's why he was the first pick in the OJLL coming out of the midget draft, and why he is one to keep an eye on down the road. Pass behind the net. Dodge is immediately picked up by Riggs. A couple of big bodies facing off. Katowski's shot blocked. Dunford, he may have been off to the races if he caught that. He didn't. Here's Wright. I think everyone kind of slowed down for a sec because the play was blown down and blown back in. And is that a goal?
Yes, it is. And that's not McGrath again, is it? I think it is McGrath.
My goodness. Buck. We're hearing Buck.
I thought it. Well, let's take a look.
Let's see. We'll see.
It's 2 or 22, but we're gonna see here. Okay, look. McGrath makes the pass and Buck puts it in. Yes, our producer Rusty called it right. And nice finish.
In my experience, the producers and the cameramen are pretty much always right.
They are.
If we're the announcers like us, will be sitting there speculating, and the camera is right on the player who scored the goal.
And I think I had that wrong. I said Buck had a couple of goals earlier. I think that's just his second goal of the game. So right now, Buck's got 9 goals to lead the tournament.
Ong again under pressure, gets away from Noseworthy, gets it out, flicks it back up to Onagi. He'll stay. Here is a rip from the outside by Ong, taking advantage of his offensive shift. Here comes Will Cecile. He's slowing down, but he could be decoying. We've seen him kind of play possum and then go to the net. But that time he did just circle around, hand it off to the offense. We're into the final minute and a half. It's 10-1 East. Buck, they've got 13 on the shot clock. Davis hits Q and gets the return pass, the give and go.
These guys are demoralized right now, the West, and they need this period to end soon, this half to end soon, to go regroup and just start fresh, because how many times have guys been wide open? And that's nice finish by Davis. But look at all the room. The defender is just watching.
That's Caden Onagi, the forward.
Who's not usually a defender.
Yeah. He was actually walking the other direction as the player cut in behind him. Boy. Dunford comes up with it. Bakta takes this one. Anderson around with a hard rip, gets it over the net. Ball behind the net. Shot clock's going to run out on Bakta, who is in there trying to get the loose ball. We're into the final 47. Here's Marshall, just bangs his way through Brendan Boyle. And a little bump from Gutowski, who is there for the outlet pass. The offense spread, starting to work their way in. Illegal pick called on Kluchuk. He will hustle back and strip the ball away from Pouliot. Pouliot's going to track it down first, but nice trail check by Kluchuk. Pouliot will take his time, the Rosemere, Quebec native, giving it to Q. Gartner watching Q and eyeing to see where his help is. This is Davis. Agus on him. The pass up. Q has it. Ong right on his hands. The one-hand shot. It was the final couple seconds of the shot clock, so we kind of pressed that one. And there's only about a second left that's going to run out. So we're going to go to halftime with the score 11-1 in favor of Canada East. And Shanny, it's what do you even do when you come out if you're Canada West?
I think you just have to ignore the score and come out and say, let's play a good half. 0-0, let's play a good half.
Win because, the third quarter?
Yeah, you know, because they really, they looked demoralized. You know, mistakes upon mistakes, and they're just obviously not feeling good about themselves. But, you know, sometimes the mistakes are piling on each other. You just have to say, okay, let's forget about this. Let's come out and have a good half. Like, they had a good quarter at the end of the day yesterday.
Understandable. We will go to the halftime break, and we will be right back at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship on TSN. Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship Game 3 here at the Canada Life Center in Winnipeg, Manitoba. I am Stephen Stamp, joined by Brian Shanahan. And Shanny, I'm going to get right to your highlights because you've got a lot of Canada East goals to get through here.
Yeah, you know, it's hard to believe that it was 2-1 early in the second quarter, and then we had a 9-goal run. But we're going to look at every one of these goals. This is to start the game. That was a power play goal by McGrath. Nice assist by Q. You're going to hear a lot from both of them. After that, McGrath scores his second goal. Defender tried to intercept the pass. He got wide open. And then this was early in the quarter, second quarter, to make it 2-1. But that was the only good news for the West, because then Q scores a nice goal on a bit of a screenshot. And after that, you're going to see some turnovers. You're going to see some men get open. There's McGrath coming from the bench for a fast break goal. That made it 4-1. I believe Buck scores that one to make it 5-1. Eddie Q, watch this nice pass to Anderson over the shoulder. Another nice goal. Too much room for Anderson in front of the net. That's when they changed goalies. Ruska came out. He didn't play bad. It was just, you know, the team wasn't doing well in front of him. Getty comes in, and McGrath gets another chance, another breakaway, scores the goal. Another man open here. McGrath again. I think I made it 8-1. He's having a night. And watch Eddie Q again. Bowl his way through three guys to the net, and Trumbull gets the rebound to put it in. I think this is the one from Buck. McGrath to Buck, quick stick in the net. And we weren't finished yet. Davis. Yeah, Eddie Q to Davis. That was a give and go back and forth. And 11-1.
We'll take a break and we'll be back with more analysis and get ready for the second half here at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship on TSN. Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship here at the Canada Life Center. I am Stephen Stamp, joined by Brian Shanahan, and it's 11-1. One thing I wanted to touch on, a viewer tweeted at us, a nice reminder, because when we saw Aiden Danby go down, and Tanner Buck went over and was consoling him and talking to him, they were actually teammates for Canada at the E-Box tournament in Prague a couple of years ago. And they've been together. They're, you know, they're friends, and it was a nice moment to see Buck going over and supporting him. And I really like that Buck just said, no, go ahead, blow the whistle.
No, you're right. I'm looking at the shots on net. Stamper 32-6 for the East.
32-6.
Ruska has allowed 6 goals on 24 shots. They pulled him, not his fault. You know, sometimes you pull and hope something good happens. It didn't happen. And 5 goals on 8 shots against Getty. That doesn't sound good, but I'm not blaming him, because the quality of those shots, that was when things sort of started falling apart for the West. And those 8 shots, many of them were wide open guys. You cannot let Buck, McGrath, Anderson wide open on the net. So I don't blame either goalie for what the score is at this point.
So if you're the coach, what do you do for the third quarter for Canada?
Well, you know what? I'd put Ruska back in net, and that's not a statement towards how Getty is playing. I think I'd just reward him, saying, you know, you did all right. We gave you a little rest. I want you to come back in. And then if I'm the West, at this point, I say, tighten up our defense. Let's play with some pride. tighten up the defense. Forget about what the score is. Let's come out and win this quarter. That's it. Win this quarter. Don't even worry about the half. Win the quarter. And if that works, you'll go into the next quarter the same way. You got to have small victories.
And have some fun.
Yeah.
Don't be dejected. Come out and have some fun. This is a big event, a big experience. Get the most out of it. It's also not just about the wins.
But also, play in front of your goalies. Yeah. Your goalies deserve, for the defense to play as hard as they can. And I'm not laying all the blame on the defense. There's a couple times where a few offensive players got stuck on D and, you know, made the same mistakes that, you know, other guys are making. But I'd love to see the West have a strong period, because I want them to go out of this tournament feeling good about themselves.
Yeah. And we don't want to pick on the West too much.
No.
We haven't maybe given enough credit to Canada.
Well, that's, you know,
how
what?
Excellent they've been.
That's another thing is you've got some scorers that cash in on mistakes. Just, you know, if you make the slightest mistake, they make you pay. From what Eddie Q, Anderson, McGrath, a Buck. These guys are so talented. You just slip up for half a second. You miss your man for half a second, and the ball is in their sticks, and you see the way they've got finish around their around the goaltenders. You know, McGrath has shown great hands. For a guy who plays defense in the OJ for Orangeville, he plays defense. He's got 5 goals today, and we've seen the nifty hand work.
And even if you make a little mistake in the offensive zone, there are times when that's coming back the other way and it's in the back of your net before you know it.
Well, that's the other, what's led to some transition goals. You know, a bad turnover in the offensive zone. So, I don't want to lay all the blame at the defense.
We just saw Canada West coming up the tunnel and they looked a bit like a team that's down 11-1. Again, hopefully they can have a good third quarter here. Canada East is heading to their bench now. I am Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan.
And that, I don't know if we mentioned, that was a 9-goal run. I mean, that the East are still on. 2-1 early in that second quarter. And, 9 straight goals. That's, without a doubt, the longest run, the biggest run we've seen in this tournament so far.
Yeah, and remember, it was 2-0 quickly, 2.5 minutes, right?
Yeah.
And then there was an 8-minute stretch where Canada West played very well. Then they get a goal. And it was really looking like they were finding something.
And that goal, Eddie Q's goal that made it 3-1, I don't think that was just a nice goal. I don't think there was any mistakes made by the defense, and, you know, Eddie Q earned that. But, after that, things seemed to fall apart.
Aki Onagi at the dot. Roger Nurse ready to blow the whistle. He does, and off we go. Onagi tried to pull it back, then Aki tried to, and the ball's still down there. It pops out, and Caden Noseworthy gets it, but it gets away from him, and Ong has it for Canada West. First possession of the second half. Leaves it for Oakey, who goes to Miller. This is Gutowski at the top, giving it to Basisti. Now Canada West finally getting the ball deeper. They get the shot. Kells turns it aside. Another save. He's just increased his number of shots by 25% and does it with a couple of saves.
Some pretty quick math there, Stamper.
Trumbull over center, watched closely by Marshall. This is Buck waiting for the finish to complete. Hayden Coulter gets it back to him. Buck shot over top. Getty is still between the pipes for Canada West. Dunford kind of taps up all the way. They've got 4 to get a shot off. McGrath will rip one. Going for the sock trick. Here comes Canada West getting the ball ahead to Patrick Dodds. Very quiet night for Dodds. We've barely even seen him have a chance to handle the ball. A lot of the Canada West offense just not seeming to get a lot of chances. Here's one. The pick by Moon. The roll and back. Oh, and the illegal pick.
I thought they were going to let him get away with it. I think they were going to let him get away with that.
It's almost
pick
a play
until,
on.
Until it turned into a scoring chance. It was like the ref had second thoughts.
Buck takes that pass. Immediately back to Davis. Ong on Buck. Craig Wilkin on Davis as he gets that return pass. Oh, it's reached out by Ong. Almost had it. Davis, nice job to take it away, because I don't know if anybody was catching Ong on that one. The shot clock will expire. A couple of Canada East defenders already on the floor as Canada West picks up the ball when the buzzer goes. Oakey under some pressure from Matt Wright, way up high. You see the confidence of these Canada East defenders. they're willing to go put pressure on anywhere on the floor, basically, because they feel like they've got support and they feel like they can recover. Here's Wright and Aki playing the defensive two-man game. Shot from Basisti, right back to himself. Oh, it's picked up by Oakey. Nice save by Kells. It hit the post, I think, but I thought it went off Kells first.
I think he made the first save, but I think the rebound did go off the post. But here's Aki. Say Kells took away all the angle. That was the only thing he could shoot at.
Buck to... Hands off to Anderson. Here's McGrath, shoots around the screen. Don't think it touched anything, and it's gonna go into the bench. So that will be Canada West possession. Keen Moon, we'll see what he can do. He's been pretty spectacular. We mentioned 5 goals, everyone jumping up and dunking over the goalie. Here's Dodds, quick pass. Oh, Nagy tries to get under, Pouliot spins past him, steps around, just misses far side. Comes straight out to Miller, though.
One of their nicest opportunities, but the shot has got to be on the net.
I like the responsibility. Oh, here's Onagi. That's tipped away, but Patrick Dodds, the captain, was already back at center when that ball was recovered. So even down 11-1, they're thinking the right way. Get a defender back, or get someone back so you can get the defense out, take away transition. And you were talking about that. Play the game right. Support your goalie. Come out and try and win the quarter. Still 0-0 in this quarter. Pass down low to Q. He hits Anderson. Bobbles out of his stick. Oh, that's back in. And Marshall knew it was a risk. Almost looked like he was going to pass the ball to himself on the far side, because if he just lets go of it and then runs through, it's okay. But that was a lot to think of in not much time. Gets away from Davis. 20 on the shot clock. There's a pass. Nice recovery by Krywoken to keep McGrath away from the net. Coulter gets underneath, shoots, that's off the foot slash post. And it's picked up by McGrath, fresh 30 for Canada East. Davis down low, this is Anderson watched by Susie. Anderson, Davis. McGrath's shot, again a foot save, and Getty will reach out to get that one. Pass ahead, gets away from Oakey, and as he looks up, Riggs is all over him. That must be about the worst thing you can see as a forward in that position, is to look up from the having your head down and see Riggs steaming at you.
And the East has done such a great job of doing that all game.
Yeah, if there's any hesitation in the clear, they have somebody on the Canada West player. That was off an East player, so it's not over and back, but they've only got 2 seconds on the shot clock. And that basically turns into a pass from Dodds to Kells. He tried to go for the low shot, try and get a rebound. And that's hard from that distance. Here's Buck. He's isolated. There was nobody on this side of the floor with him. And Brockmeyer was just holding his position. Now Dunford is out there for the offensive shift. Takes it from Davis. They do have 3 lefties. Oh, my goodness. Buck to left all alone. But he's stopped by Getty. And that will take us to our first break of the quarter. We'll be back at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship on TSN. BioSteel is proud to be hydrating the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Zero sugar and eco-friendly sports hydration. Head to biosteel.ca to get yours today.
Stamper, not a bad start to this quarter for the West. The shots are 4-4. Considering it was 19-1 in the last quarter, that's a huge improvement.
Now let's see if they can get the offense going as Onagi starts with it. A little pick by Kluchuk. Another one as the ball is away. Here's Dodds getting a pick. Tries to come around it. Nice defense, though. That was Michael Grace fighting off the pick. Katowski fighting for the ball. Taps behind him, and Onagi has it. He's got to shoot. 2 on the clock. Tries the pass, it's picked off by Grace. There wasn't going to be time anyway, but nice stick by Michael Grace. He's been very quietly effective.
Well, we mentioned it earlier on when there was a two-on-one in a two-man game, Grace had a stick in the right spot. He seems to have a knack for getting his stick in the passing lane, and sometimes that's just a habit. Hold your stick up, and the ball actually hits your stick.
Eddie Hughes steps in the crease and hands it over to Evan Susie. He looked like he was thinking dunk. You could just see, because players getting that chance, they know they can go for that dunk, and they get it. You can see their eyes getting big when an opportunity to it from behind arises. Here's Moon over to Batisti and back. Dodds surveys the floor. Double screen, shoots, shoulder save by Kells, who calmly pulls it in, and a penalty coming. It's going to be illegal change. This illegal substitution, too many men.
First penalty to the East. The West took a penalty early in the game. I think it was McGrath's first goal was on a power play. And we're going to see the West is going to get a chance to score.
Yeah, Nathan Pouliot will go to serve that as the in-home player.
Now watch the West, the East defenders. They're very active, and their sticks are very active. And you mentioned Grace, and I agree with you. I think he's been very effective playing on the top of the box along with Wright. But it's the sticks that are always in the passing lanes.
And Aki and Riggs are down low. Here's Gutowski up to Pasisti, over to Dodds. You've got Moon and Miller there. They stay with the lefties for now, skip it over to Dodds. Thought about the shot, skip pass down. Moon goes up to the top. Boy, they get on him quickly. Matt Wright is right there. Nice play, Ethan Riggs, as they go for the back door.
I think Riggs deflected that pass, did you?
Just got a bit of it.
Yep.
Tiniest bit, that's all you need. Here comes Wright, taking his time, no pressure yet. Marshall on him. Marshall and Brockmeyer, you can see them working together, make sure Wright doesn't have anywhere to go, so they give it to Q. Haggis, matched up on him, and there's Brockmeyer. Kind of playing free safety while he waits for Hayden Coulter to get out of the floor. Oh, what a pass to Buck, the save, though, by Getty. Great catch in
that,
traffic.
That was almost like a quarterback throwing a ball to where he thought the receiver's going to be. From Q to Buck. Nice play.
And the catch, and I mean, the defense wasn't bad. Like we say, you see times where it's just perfect pass can beat just about any defense. Gutowski tries to feed one through. There was no lane. There's a backdoor quick stick by Moon. Nice job by Kells to be in position. And you know, you got to give Kells credit because it's not always easy. We used to see Ken Dryden. We're aging ourselves by dating ourselves by saying that. But remember, Ken Dryden would hardly face any
on
shots.
A stick, yeah.
Yeah, and he would just be leaning that back. But when the time came, he was ready. Kells doing very well. Davis down to Dunford for an offensive shift. He's had a couple this quarter. All the East forwards are high, and now Anderson is backpedaling towards the bench.
Just 7 seconds to go on this power play, so looks like the East is going to successfully kill this.
Yeah, getting Dunford a little time up front on the penalty kill. He's so quick that I think you just let him run around for a bit to kill some time. Back at full strength, and the shot almost fooled Kells. Basisti kind of crossed him up a little. Now Basisti gets the loose ball back. Youngest player in the tournament, playing quite well. Definitely in spurts, he's been very good. Onagi with Wright on him. You see the little juke and jive, and Wright just does not go for it.
No, not that time. Onagi's got a nice underhand fake that we've seen him freeze players with a number of times.
Heady Q with it. The change completing as Anderson comes up top. He'll go down to Coulter. Marshall goes out on him. There's lots of room as they isolate it out. But comes up to the top. McGrath skips it over to Anderson with 5 on the shot clock here. Q goes to McGrath. Gets away. That may have been tipped by Ong. And he's going to get the ball. He's got Gartner ahead. But East defender's coming out. So he's just going to have to slow it down. Miller finds Kluchuk, who looked behind him as Dodds was coming, casting a bit of a shadow on him. Hard shot, another save by Kells. That was a good, that's the sidearm.
Yeah, that looked like a nice glove save by Kells.
Onagi with the kind of low to high, little riser. This one through the middle to Davis. And Dunford's back out there.
He's got a couple assists, I believe, this game.
Looking to get the pass, but Davis is going to drag it down and try and get a shot off instead. It's not there. 4 to shoot. Buck's going to have to let one go. Twister, and it's going to be a reset. Getty couldn't quite control the rebound, and Anderson snags it. Susie all over him. Sidearm shot stopped. got a call. It's going to be a turnover, but we are going to break with 4:17 to go here in the third quarter. This is the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship. We'll be right back after this quick message. Tech Savvy is a proud sponsor of the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Visit techsavvy.com/CLL for affordable Canada-wide internet plans. It is 11-1 here in the third quarter. We've gone 11 and a half minutes without a goal.
Without a goal. Shots 7-5 for the West in this quarter. So they've got to be pleased with what they've been able to do defensively. Now they'd love to score a goal as well.
Anderson feeds McGraw. Here's Davis with a lane. He almost couldn't believe it was that wide open. Shoots it straight back to himself off the boards.
Very nice save by Getty on that rebound off the boards.
So tough for the goalie when it comes out quickly like that. And hard for the defenders on that play because they're turned. They have to turn back to look and then get around to find their player. So Getty bails them out. That pass doesn't connect. That was a low pass for McGraw. And Getty reaches out and snags it.
Yeah, you always hear coaches talk about boxing out, and it's
they might not make the 8 seconds. Sorry, Shanny.
No, I think you're right. They didn't. And you'll see what teams, what good teams will do on a rebound. Instead of spinning around looking to see where that ball went, they will just take a man, just box him out, make sure nobody can pick up that rebound.
Yeah, you're almost better off just letting the ball come out. Shot by Q, turned aside by Getty, and then.
Yeah, you might not get the ground ball or the loose ball, but the other guy won't get a slam dunk rebound. That's what you want to avoid.
Over and back. Here's a break for Moon.
Yeah, and the East cannot get control of that ball because of the over and back. The referee was waiting to see if Moon was going to get a breakaway.
Yeah, and it rolled too far. It was going to be an open look in front of the net, so he sends Moon off into the corner to start with possession. Here's Onagi trying to get under. Brendan Boyle, nothing flashy, but boy, is he solid. Oh, what a finish,
nice goal.
Nolan Oakey. Beautiful pass from Gutowski, the West assist leader. Don't know if he's the tournament leader anymore because there have been a lot of goals
No, you're right. But yes, another assist for it by Gutowski. And this was good ball movement. It goes through about four players before it eventually goes in. That's really nice. I've really enjoyed the game by Gutowski. The last few games, all the assists he's made. He's got good vision on the floor, and that's a nice backhand pass. And Oakley kind of slam dunks it in.
The other part of the play by Gutowski is there's Oakley on the bench. He falls as he makes the pass, lands. His foot hit he kept his body out of the crease. His hand landed on the crease line. And he lifted his hand up sure he was out of the crease.
Very subtle smarts. I didn't notice that.
Yeah. And, I mean, that would have been very hard for a ref to pick up that little hand, but they're there in position, so they could very well get it. So, love that play from Gutowski. McGrath, Anderson. Davis, a little shoulder fake. Nothing doing there. They go over to Anderson who shoots. Getty save. McGrath's got it back. Good shooting chance.
Nice save,
Getty. You were saying maybe go back to Ruska for this one. I think Getty has shown that.
Yeah, he's
probably the best choice.
Well.
He's been good. And it's 1-0 this quarter for Canada West. Davis. Watched by Ong. 17 on the shot clock. McGrath. He will rip it from outside. And the way Getty's seeing the ball, I don't think there's much chance on that one. But Ong can't quite get the outlet pass. He'll try and track it down. Gets it. Pooley out there on him. Forces him up high and into help. Dodds setting the over to Gutowski. Gutowski looks for the man off the bench. Here comes Moon. He is the last forward. Slips through. Pouliot, nice job picking him up as he did a slip pick and headed in. Now Moon will get it up high. Saved by Kells. It's right in the crease.
Oh my.
Oakley almost had it. You can reach in and pull the ball out as long as it's not under the goalie's stick.
Yeah, you can't bat a loose ball in that's lying in the crease, but you can pick it up, get possession, and throw it in.
Yeah, good point. That's why Oakley's trying to pull it back out. Big swing there by Brockmeyer, but the ball's already gone. Sperman D'ing up on Coulter and kind of or Q and kind of forces him off. That's strength on strength. That's Sperman pushing up on Eddie Q. And the shot clock is going to expire. Buck just flings it to the far corner. We haven't seen Aiden Hamby for a while. He did come out on the floor and try out that knee. And Mason McQuiggan is out. There's a shot off the shoulder of Kells. So Wes is also facing being a couple men short in this game. Here's Miller. We're into the final 30 now of the third quarter. And a penalty coming away from the play. Illegal cross check on Patrick Dodds. Did he not get one yesterday? Or one of the West players got a one on an aggressive
on
pick.
On offense, yes.
Yeah.
And I didn't see it, but I'm going to guess that that's what it was. We're going to have a look. There's Dodds, number 66. Let's watch. Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. So
got it high.
He meant to throw a pick. It looks like he actually is apologizing, too.
Yeah. And, I mean, Patrick Dodds is 6'3". And Blake Dunford, says it's 6 feet. It looks like a bit more of a difference. 20 seconds to go. Kells has stayed in. No need to pull the goalie when you're already in the power play. Anderson flips it over his shoulder to Coulter, who shoots. Comes straight back to Anderson. They got 6 seconds. Anderson backdoor to McGrath. There's Q. Great lane opens up. Ong just waiting for the ball. He's going to run out of time. And we're going to run out of time in this third quarter. We will take a quick break and come back to the World Junior Lacrosse Championship here on TSN. Welcome back, lacrosse friends, to the World Junior Championship. And Eddie Q has been outstanding in this tournament. Let's learn a bit more about the young man from Mississauga.
I grew up playing Mississauga Tomahawks for my entire minor career and was drafted first overall to Barry in the Junior A draft. And shortly after that, I was recruited to Yale to play lacrosse and be a student there. And this last year was my first year. With the pandemic and everything, didn't get to play lacrosse, but still an amazing experience. And now being selected to play in this tournament is an awesome opportunity to wear the Maple Leaf, and couldn't be more proud of that.
And Eddie Q's had some nice highlights this weekend. I think he's got 5 goals, 4 assists so far. But, you know, I'll tell you what a coach, I spoke to a coach as we watched this who coached him in minor lacrosse in Mississauga. What he said is, Eddie's my favorite all-time player that I coach, wants to win, mature, intelligent, coachable, and, of course, talented. And we've seen all of that in this tournament. I love watching this guy. And you've mentioned a number of times, was drafted number one in the Ontario Junior Lacrosse Draft. But, you know, what a player. And we're gonna hear a lot more from him. He's just, you know, more or less starting his junior career.
And way down the road, when he is done playing, he may have a broadcasting career. Ah. But we did that, those little interviews. Everyone did well, but Eddie Q, we call him One Take Q, because we said, here's what we'd like you to touch on. We want it to be 30 seconds. We can do, you know, do one thing. We can shoot a bit more. They can edit it together. Eddie Q rolled that off, 30 seconds to the dot, perfect.
I was kidding earlier about, you know, he's going to Yale University.
Yes.
You know, he's a smart guy. And I should mention that coach that was talking, that's Jimmy Smith, who coached him in Mississauga, and all-time favorite player, and good for him. He's had a great tournament. He's been one of the most dominant players offensively for East. Of course, you know, Tanner Buck's put in a lot of goals, and McGraw, we've seen a lot of players shining.
Aki and Onagi fighting for the loose ball off. They're fighting for the faceoff, and it is Aki that pulls it back to Michael Grace. Here's Buck as we get going on the fourth quarter of the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship here in Winnipeg, Manitoba. I'm Steven Stamp with Brian Shanahan. Backdoor pass. Coulter didn't have it before he shot. Susie with pressure. Can he find the outlet? Maybe not in front of your bench, in front of your net, Evan. He was just looking for the outlet, knowing he's only got 8 seconds. You got to try and do something, a bit of desperation.
And you know, give some credit to the East. They're all over these guys. And we can see who's open from up here.
Yeah.
But when they got two bodies come at you quickly,
and
it
you're
kind of blinds you.
To turn,
exactly.
Yeah, it shouldn't have been so mean.
It's a much easier game for us up here.
Buck with the shot. Nice block by Agus.
Play. Yes.
McGraw goes behind the net to Buck. Q can't quite catch that one. It rolls all the way through to Getty.
And the behind the net play is so tough for a goaltender, because the goalie's got to back up right on that net.
Especially when you're shorthanded.
Yeah, and when
somebody's going to be open.
And when when he backs up, when a goalie, to stop the dunk, they have to back up on the net. And then when the pass goes in front, all of a sudden the goalie is too far in his net to stop an outside shot.
Eddie Q with it, just looking up. They're going to wait till this penalty expires in 4 seconds.
Yeah, and you wonder, why will a team not take a late shot on the power play? And usually they don't, because the guy's coming out of the penalty box. So they don't want that shot, that save, that rebound for the ball to go up to the floor for a breakaway for that guy who's just stepping out of the penalty box. And most teams you will see will wait. They'll wait for the guy to come out of the penalty box and run back before the shoot.
Nice clearing pass by Sean Krywoken up to Keen Moon.
And did we even mention the West won that last quarter?
1-0. I was going to say 2-0 for the East in the first, then 9-1 in the second. Here's a chance. Oh, what a shot, Matt, right in transition on the run, underhand. Perfect five-hole placement.
And Matt Wright, another one of our favorite players in this tournament, and he does this with ease. He runs the ball. He never seems to get in trouble running out of his own end. He's got some great speed. Great finish, very unselfish. If he doesn't think there's an opportunity, he curls up and passes the ball. But that time he thought, I think I could put this shot in.
That was a very nice pass to Wright. I didn't catch who it was, so we'll see who gets the assist. But yeah, it was a very low scoring first quarter, 2-0 Canada East, then 9-1 in the second, so high scoring, and then just 1-0 in the third. Now we do have some goals coming here in the fourth. Canada East with possession off the draw. Davis takes it. Grace stays up for an offensive shift. Buck in the corner, slips behind his man. They don't quite connect on the pass. Oh, he was cutting into space. Here's Buck to get a pick. The roll is wide open for Coulter. Stopped by Getty.
So it looks like it was... Who made that last pass on that last goal was Lee McGrath.
The assists were credit to McGrath and Q, which I don't think is right. Why?
No,
they weren't caught back on D, were they? Here is the pass up to Kluchuk, gets away from him. And Trumbull will just run into Pasisti and let Kluchuk pick up the ball.
And we forgot to give credit to Getty for making another nice save. Another man wide open to Hayden Coulter on that last scoring chance. And they've just been slipping open time after time against Getty. He's really settled in and had a great game for himself, but he stepped into a fire.
And in practices, I remember some of the West players saying to Getty, you just don't go for fakes. You have a knack for telling when it's a fake and when it's not. Here's a nice cut underneath, but noseworthy on an offensive shift, but another save by Getty.
Look at this, they take his space away real quick.
Oh, what a nice goal! Tyler Davis off the bench. Arthur Miller off the bench.
And who made that pass? I think it might have been Sam Marshall.
That's a beauty.
We're going to see. It actually looked like the West was in trouble once again as they stepped over the line. And Getty's going to get an assist here. I think this is Marshall running into traffic and makes a perfect pass, a perfect catch by Miller. And he puts it in as he tumbles to the ground.
Past Mitch Dunham, who has come into net for Canada East.
I missed that.
Yeah, the pass was great. The finish was great. Maybe the catch was the best part. To be going through the net that fast, have to reach back and up a bit.
Yeah, that was a nice catch.
Here's Matt Wright, stutter stepping. And again, very calmly gets it over to the corner. This is Pouliot for an offensive shift. Over to Davis. Nice D by Ong on Buck. And then Davis fights his way to the net. Couple of Canada West defenders on the floor. They get back up. It was Susie and Brockmeyer. Now Brockmeyer comes to hit Pouliot, who tried a shot. Ong is ahead. But again, a couple of defenders out for Canada West. East. Onagi way up high, waiting for the... Switch to finish, gets it back, rips it and scores on the far side. Perfect
nice
placement.
Shot by Onagi.
Just inside the post.
And Onagi got a hat trick yesterday. It was yesterday, right? He got the hat trick?
Yes, last two goals of the game.
a nice outside shot. It goes east to west to back east. And yeah, he gets time to wind up. And then for the most part, the East players have not allowed guys to wind up like that. They've done a great job of getting on their sticks or getting sticks in the lanes. And then this time Onagi gets to one. I guess it's confusing when I say it goes east to west. An expression of lacrosse that we usually say from side to side. We often say east to west, but I guess it's confusing when the teams out here are east and west. I shouldn't say that.
And Justin Getty showing off his passing skills as he gets another assist on that one, starting the breakout.
So he's assisted the last two goals. And the official stats have that last goal by the East wrong. That was the one by Wright. And we're trying to figure out who got the assist. They actually said that Will Cecile got it from McGrath and or McGrath, sorry, and Wright. And we know that's not correct.
I think Cecile may have been the pass. I thought I saw an
eight. Yeah, but they said Cecile got the goal.
I didn't.
But no, he didn't. But yeah, he may have made the pass.
I thought I saw an eight, but I was thinking 18. Maybe I was just transposing. So I think that was Cecile under pressure on the bench. Now we're going to have a discussion amongst the officials to see what they want to call in this circumstance. And it's an over and back. And we've got 10:02 to go. I thought for a second they were actually going to call the media timeout, but they will start things up and we'll get it on the next non-goal stoppage. So Canada West with the ball, Keen Moon. I want to mention the nice pass Keen Moon made to Onagi for that last West goal. Just a couple of steps down to draw his defender and draw the eyes down before he went to Onagi, which helped, as you're saying, Onagi have more space than the West shooters have been used to having. Moon now, it just opens up and he rips it with a save by Dunham. Kluchuk garners in that ball off the boards. Here's Dodds. Here's Kluchuk. There's Moon with some space. Steps out, sidearm shot, it's wide. That's gonna go over and back. Oh no, it's touched, so it won't be over and back, but it won't matter as nobody's near. Caden Noseworthy. He's got Trumbull with him. Buck coming off on the far side, and Agus quickly on him. Davis. Here's Buck. Started underneath, comes back over the top, and Ong, great recovery. Twister stopped by Getty. Here's Schmerman, looking up the floor. Nice pass to Ong. He's on his offside, switches hands. There's no offside for Easton Ong, he switches.
He's very comfortable moving back and forth.
Hustling out is Marshall to pick up Anderson before he could be left alone on the long outlet pass. East will set up. Buck flip back. Davis rips it and Getty stops that one.
And that last goal by the West by Onagi, could tell us we mentioned Getty.
There might be another one.
Oh,
there
my.
Is. Another Arthur Miller transition break. And again, it's coming from Sam Marshall. Those two are on fire in the last few minutes.
What a great play. And it, this is like a replay of that earlier goal. And I think it was it Getty who fed it up to Marshall again?
I think so. Oh, yeah, there he is.
This we might as well be showing a replay of the previous goal. Getty up to Marshall. Miller off the bench. Oh, my. Just like the last time.
And great replay in the booth there, guys. Thanks for showing that one right from the start. And you see how quickly that one evolved. That's 12-5. You gotta like to see this for West, that they're keeping playing hard. Aki Onagi again battling. It's in the feet. Aki tries to scoop it and the ball comes flinging out of there. Wright will be the first one there. I feel like we've said that before.
And I was saying a while ago, I think Getty's now got three assists, if we're correct about that other one. Gutowski's got three assists as well. Three or four, I forget. Let me check this.
Here comes Q fighting through the dive and another save by Getty. He's a big fella. They call him the big man. That's one of his nickname with his teammates. But he moves so well. So such a large fella. 6'5", 230 listed. Very athletic. Again, he was a second-round draft pick by Calgary, where he will be in competition with Lane Ruschka sorry, with Landon Kells.
Landon Kells, yeah.
Yeah, for the backup position to young phenom Christian Del Bianco. Basisti with the pass after picking up the loose ball. Just missed Keen Moon. Did someone get a stick on that? Or?
I don't think so.
That will take us to the break with 7:20 to go. It's 12-5 Canada East. We'll be back at the World Junior Lacrosse Championship after this quick break. Come back to TSN. BioSteel is proud to be hydrating the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Zero sugar and eco-friendly sports hydration. Head to biosteel.ca to get yours today. We are back. It's 12-5 here in the fourth quarter of Game 3 of the World Junior Lacrosse Championship in Winnipeg. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. Pleased to have you all along with us on TSN. We're very excited to be back on TSN with lacrosse.
Oh, yes. And all the lacrosse fans in Canada are very excited about it, too. We've been hearing from a lot of them.
McGrath to Buck. Nice two-man defense there. And then Agus staying well with McGrath on that lefty side. Here's Pouliot. Oh, what a rip from the Quebecois. He had one or two offensive shifts earlier, and he makes the most of this one.
Yeah, that was a nice shot. And Pouliot, as you said, a defender, a strong defender, has played very well for Canada East. Just steps around, takes an outside shot, in top corner. Nice play. But see all that traffic there? It's tough for the man to follow him, for the defender to follow him, because he just goes tight on the his teammates and gets that good shot.
Yeah, showing some good offensive skills. Like you said, going close to the pick. That's not over and back, if you're wondering. You can go back over center as long as you haven't headed towards the other net first, off the faceoff. You can go back over center through one zone. Excellent call there. Or non-call, I guess. Cued back door to Dunford, just a little bit away from him. Grabbed by Krywoken.
He's gonna run out of time.
Did they make it? No, they made it with a second to spare. Thanks to the speed of Easton Ong after that nice outlet pass. Krywoken from Airdrie, Alberta. Plays for the Okotoks Junior A. Pride of Airdrie. He's had a strong tournament. Here's Moon. Thought about the shot. Not there. It goes to Gutowski. Hard rip by Oakey. Dodds is pushed down by Riggs. Again, the two big units banging in together. In that case, it was a loose ball foul. This pass will come to Dodds. He's going to let it fly. Nice save Dunham. Loose ball almost picked up by Oakey. He was through the crease. He can't pick that up. You'll have to put it down, and Eddie Q will get it. You can't, as an offensive player, run through the crease and then be the first player to play the ball. Although you might as well pick it up there because nobody else is getting to it.
Yeah.
So just pick it up and hope they didn't see.
And that doesn't happen often.
No. They're pretty much on top of that. Here's Anderson. Little reach for the pass by Noseworthy. He goes wide open to the net and scores. The defender's getting some chances and taking them for Canada East.
Well, you said it. A couple of defenders and Coach Dowling is rewarding these guys for some defense throughout the tournament, saying go up and have a little fun, play some offense and see what you can do. And they're making the most of their opportunities. And Noseworthy just too easily takes it to the net. And this is tough for goalie because you always expect that dive to the far side and he goes short side, showing some great skill.
Oh, Nagy with the quick clamp, and Aki so strong. He's able to contest this. Again, they've gone now 720 degree rotation by the faceoff guys. Strength and balance. So they lean on each other there. Ong whipping up over center. Oh, it pops away from him. He didn't know where it went. It had actually gone straight ahead. If he just kept running, he might have had a chance to get it back. But so hard when the ball just sneaks out. You don't necessarily
notice. I think Dunford knocked that out. I think Dunford
did
that.
The trail check?
Yeah.
Marshall getting a stick in the way of that Davis pass, but it bounces over to Buck. 12 on the shot clock for the East. McGrath to Buck. Sidearm shot off the post. Not over and back, of course, as it pings off the post, so it'll be a fresh 30. The buzzer went because they hadn't reset it, just because it hadn't been picked up yet. But no violation. 23 seconds to shoot for Canada East. Coulter.
Oh.
Runs into space, but Schmermand was there to contest it. A little too much room, though, to let him shoot. But nice save again by Getty. Here's Marshall. Marshall was looking for Arthur Miller, because every time he passes it to him, he scores.
Yeah.
But Miller's on the bench. It's not his shift, so he'll just hand it over, and West goes through their offense. Oh, Nagy, nice pick to get the shot off.
He got the wind-up big then again, but this time Dunham was out. Took the angle away. That ball wasn't going anywhere.
Yeah, Troy Gutowski, nice pick there. He has really come on. The first game, I thought he looked tentative and not really comfortable. He looked better last game, and he's made some really nice plays tonight. Buck gets the pick from McGraw. Just swimming around. It's loose. McGraw grabs it. Four to shoot. He's going to just try and get one off. Goes cross-handed.
And I love seeing Buck do that swim move. Usually you don't see guys that are 5'9" do swim moves.
We are going to take our final break here during playing time of the World Junior Lacrosse Championship 2021. And we'll be right back on TSN. Tech Savvy is a proud sponsor of the 2021 and 2022 IIJL World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Visit techsavvy.com/CLL for affordable Canada-wide internet plans. Take a look at Canada East bench there, Shanny.
Yeah, Coach Dowling has done a great job with these guys. And, you know, we've mentioned a number of times, you know, the East team's a little bit older, a little bit more experienced, and he's really gelled them together nicely. And I guess we should also add the fact that most of these guys play in a smaller. They're all from Ontario. They all play against each other. I've seen each other many times where the West team is a little bit more spread out, a little more difficult to bring all these guys together to get them to gel. But Jeff Dowling has done a great job.
Dodds rears back and fires, and what a finish.
Nice.
Nolan Oakey, right spot at the right time to tuck it home.
And in case anybody's wondering, we said, you know, when they were down 11-1 at half, we said the West, they have to come out and try to win the quarter. Maybe win the half if they win the quarter. They did win the quarter, 1-0, and now they're up 4-3 in the last quarter. And if you want to put it all together, second half, they're up 5-3. So they have responded after a very difficult first half.
All kinds of pressure after the faceoff win by West. Noseworthy and Boyle putting some pressure on. Nice job by Ong to find the outlet to Marshall. Here's Keen Moon. Nice feed through the save by Dunham, though, on that shot by Basisti. He has to dig it out of his equipment. Here is Davis, down to the corner to McGraw. That's Pouliot, and see if he can get another one. That pass doesn't connect though, and it will be West ball going the other way. Here is Keen Moon. Tried to go back to Gutowski, but wasn't there, so he goes to Kluchuk. Now it gets to Gutowski. He's going to rip one. Oh, hard one off the post. It's a race between Dodds and Aki. It rolls past Dodds. Aki picks it up.
Oh, smart play by Aki.
Hits McGraw. What a save, Getty, as McGraw was going for six.
Going for six. Great job by Aki. He realizes he's not going to get a clear-cut breakaway, but he knows the teammate's coming off the bench, so he pulls his man to the side and sets up McGraw for a potential sixth goal. And Getty, yeah, really has been great this half. I believe he's got three assists.
Moon's shot swallowed up by Dunham. Mitch Dunham wearing the unusual 0-1 between the pipes. You see some zeros, you see some ones. Don't always see them together. Yeah. coming to a final minute of this game as Eddie Q looking for an opening. Five on the shot clock. Things open up, he rips it, it's wide, and the 30 will expire. Stay with us post-game as we will have the Player of the Game Awards, we will have the All-World team announced, the medal presentation, of course, and then the World Junior Lacrosse Championship Trophy presented. Here's Bassisti, has room to step in. A reset for Canada West as it grazed off of Dunham. That pass gets away though off the boards and straight to Brendan Boyle. Matt Wright will just peel away. Final 30 of the game and this 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Obviously Canada East in no rush to go to the net. They can let the 30 expire and there will be about 6 seconds left. And I think they're actually just gonna place it. Oh, they'll roll it away. I thought McGraw might actually hand it over.
Yeah, got 5 goals in the first half and a great opportunity recently to get a sixth.
And that's it, the final buzzer, and Canada East are your 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Champions. Good work by Canada West to fight back and have a good second half, but obviously that game and this championship very much in the hands of Canada East.
Yeah, Canada East has showed themselves to be the superior team, but I agree with you. I love to see that fight that the West showed in the second half after being down 11-1. They didn't quit, they clawed back, and they won the second half. So good for them, small victories. And yeah, we saw a lot of good play from a lot of players from both teams. And I guess, are we gonna have the MVPs first?
We are, we're gonna start with the players of the game. Will be presented as they roll out the table. And could that be foreshadowing? We said the camera guys and the producer are pretty much always right, and they are following Liam McGraw as he walks along behind his line of teammates.
Well, I could say I officially don't know, but I would say McGraw for the East. For the West, let me think about this. Who would you pick from the West? There's a number.
I do know, I'm not going to take a guess and seem like I'm smarter than I am.
Okay. I like the way Getty played second half. Mm-hmm.
I thought about Getty.
Kutowski's got a few assists. Miller a couple goals. I don't know. I'm not going to say who it is. You know who it is. Let's wait and see who's announced.
The medals are on the table. The beautiful, beautiful trophy that is new this year is there. And again, the Player of the Game Awards will be the traditional Anishinaabe lacrosse stick. These are beautifully fashioned, very cool. We saw one of the players walking back with his award, and this time it is Nolan Oakey for Canada West.
You know what, and he's had a consistent tournament, got a couple of goals yesterday, I believe, and got a couple of goals again today. That's a good call. And I guess no question on the Team East.
Told you the camera guy and the producer had it. It wasn't hard. With 5 goals, Liam McGraw gets that beautiful commemorative stick. And the next presentation will be to the world team. And not easy decisions to make. The goaltender is Landon Kells from Canada East.
So what are we going with here? Is it like three forwards,
goalie,
two defenders?
Goalie, 2D, one transition, two forwards.
Okay, I'm
guesses on D.
I'm gonna guess. Well, I'm gonna say in transition, I like Wright, for sure.
The only flaw in your logic, I believe he is being considered a defender.
Okay, well, he's got to be out there as far as I'm concerned, and it's tough because I think a lot of guys on Canada East play great defense. Mm-hmm. And is this?
That's Matt Wright getting
Matt
the
Wright. Okay,
All good. World Defender Award.
I'm happy with that. He had a great tournament.
There'll be one more defender. Yeah, I thought Matt Wright was sensational.
And you know what? You could pick a handful of guys for this next defender.
It will be Jordan Ackey.
He played well, another worthy player. Offense, I got to think Buck.
What about transition next?
Oh, transition. Yeah, see, I would have picked right for transition. I'm not sure where this will go.
It is.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Easton Ong.
There's two teams out here, and Easton Ong played great. He played some good defense, and he probably was their best player getting the ball before.
Had a running back
beautiful
his
assist.
Team's line. He needs
beautiful
to go over
assist
them.
In that first game.
Offensive at forward.
No
Tanner
surprise
Buck.
Here, Tanner Buck.
And they're trying to get Easton Ong to go back and join the other award winners.
Yep.
And he is finally making his
figured
way over. And the final member of the 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Championship All-World Team is Patrick Dodds, the captain of Canada West.
Yep, Dodds, how many goals did he get? Dodds, I think he had 4 goals, 5 assists coming into this game.
Yeah, he was at 4-5. I think he would tell you he would like to have done a bit more, but played very well, showed a lot of his strengths.
Yeah, I got 1 assist today. So not his most explosive offensive game today, but 4 goals, 6 assists on the tournament. Pretty good, yeah, and I agree. I think he would have liked to contribute more.
And
but
you know, most
worthy
of
choice.
Yeah, most of Canada West's scoring chances in this game really came from the transition game. Like, you know, those two passes, Marshall to Arthur Miller. The silver medals now being presented. Elaine Ruschka and Justin Getty get theirs. There's Mason McQuiggan, who went out in first game. Shame to see him on the crutches, but
and
so
is,
far
is
no
Aiden
word.
Dan be out there?
We will see. Oakey, that is Basisti getting it. And behind him, Jackson Kluchuk. Yes, Danby's going to be in a couple. There's Bryce Schmermond and Troy Gutowski. Then Evan Gardner. And there is Aiden Danby, obviously disappointed not to get to finish this game out.
Yeah, obviously he doesn't have his runners on unless he played the game in his sandals.
Keen Moon and Arthur Miller. Miller with a dynamic fourth quarter.
Miller had a few nice goals in the tournament.
There's the handshake line. You can see how much these players appreciate each other.
Yeah, and you've mentioned many of these guys have played together for Canada in the past, so that a lot of these guys know each other.
Agus and Brockmeyer got them, and then Susie and Ong. Now it is Krywoken and Marshall. And finally, the final players, Onagi and Patrick Dodds. Head coach Stu Sturparn, who stepped in, has done an excellent job. He is one of the great guys in the game of lacrosse, a real up-and-coming coach.
He really is a fun guy to talk lacrosse with. Yes.
Out of Alberta. And with the Outlaws organization.
And he just loves, I mean, we chatted last night after the game, like a bunch of us, the coaches, and he's just a guy who just soaks up everything he hears. He just loves hearing stories, and you know he doesn't forget anything.
Chris Fox is the assistant coach for Canada West and the general manager of Canada overall, and he has his silver medal and will hand a gold to Landon Kells, while Stu Sturparn hands one to Mitch Dunham.
Kells was going to go shake hands with everybody. He just said, we've already done that. We've
you
done
guys
that.
Good?
We
We're
don't
good.
Need to shake again.
Cecile and Wright. Shani, I want to thank you, as we see everyone going through to get them. Thank you for being here with us. This is our second World Juniors.
I enjoyed it.
It's a lot of fun. Roomies and everything, and we're not at each other's throats. We had a good time.
It sure was, and it was some great lacrosse. I really enjoyed this, and it's great to be back calling lacrosse, mm-hmm. watching lacrosse, because just a few months ago, we thought there might not be any.
Yeah. Next year, 2022, the World Junior Lacrosse Championship will be back here in Winnipeg at the Canada Life Center. We are excited about that one. Coming back, expecting big crowds here in this building. There's going to be lots of time to build towards that, hopefully as COVID-free as possible. And we'll be rolling. And go to worldjuniorlacrossechampionship.com, and you can find all the international indoor junior lacrosse information about the upcoming championships. It's been announced where they will be for the next few years. We're going to be going to the United States. We're going to be going to Europe,
Yeah, it's going to be exciting. We know there's going to be many more teams next year, and it'll probably grow from that.
Yeah, the Haudenosaunee will be hosting in the near future. So a lot of very cool stuff coming on. And it really was a shame this year, obviously, that everyone couldn't come. We had, you know, the Anishinaabe were going to be making their debut. So we would have had two Indigenous-based teams, which I believe would have been a first in most international competition. And now the presentation of the World Junior Lacrosse Championship Trophy to the captains group, Tanner Buck, Ethan Riggs, Jordan Ackey, and Matthew Wright. A proud moment for those four men and the rest of their team with them. They'll get a little celebration in tonight.
And most of these players are here on their own. I don't think families were allowed to travel with them. So these guys have really bonded and they've really enjoyed themselves. And I think many of them will be, almost all will be flying back home tomorrow to see their families, who are all at home watching this on TSN.
Yeah, it's shouting to everyone.
Proud. Yeah, parents, you guys should be very proud.
It was all Canada, as it was Canada East and Canada West, but that is playing for Canada East, your 2021 World Junior Lacrosse Champions. I am Stephen Stamp on behalf of Brian Shanahan and Rusty and everyone in the booth who did a great job. Everyone who organized the tournament, very exciting stuff. Shani, again, thanks for being here. Thank you all for being with us. And we can't wait to see you next year at the 2022 World Junior Lacrosse Championship. Everyone, have a great night.